We are asked to identify the fractions plotted on the number line and to give the answers as proper or improper fractions, not mixed numbers. The first step is to focus on the unit, which is the length from 0 to 1 on the number line. So this length here is equal to 1 unit, and notice how the tick marks cut or divide this length into 1, 2, 3 equally sized parts or pieces, which means a length between tick marks is equal to 1/3 of a unit. Knowing this, we can now count to the right of 0 by 1/3 and to the left of 0 by negative 1/3. Counting to the right of 0, we have 0 and then 1/3, 2/3, 3/3, which is equal to 1, and 4/3. And now counting to the left of 0, we count by negative 1/3. We have negative 1/3, negative 2/3, negative 3/3, which is equal to negative 1, negative 4/3, negative 5/3, negative 6/3, which is equal to negative 2, negative 7/3, and negative 8/3. And now we have the information we need to express A, B, and C as proper or improper fractions. A is equal to negative 7/3. B is equal to negative 4/3. And C is equal to positive 2/3. So these are the answers to the question, but for review, let's also express the improper fractions as mixed numbers. So looking at negative 4/3, notice how this is 1/3 of a unit to the left of negative 1, and therefore as a mixed number, negative 4/3 is equal to negative 1 and 1/3. And now looking at negative 7/3, notice how this is 1/3 of a unit to the left of negative 2, negative 7/3 equals negative 2 and 1/3. Again, this question does want the fractions as proper fractions or improper fractions, but I think it's worth reviewing the improper fractions as mixed numbers. Let's look at a second example. Again, the first step is to focus on the length of 1 unit, which again is a distance from 0 to 1. Notice how this length is cut or divided into 1, 2, 3, 4 equally sized parts or pieces, which means the length between tick marks equals 1/4 of a unit. So now we can count by 1/4 to the right of 0, and we can count by negative 1/4 to the left of 0. Starting at 0, moving to the right, we have 0, 1/4, 2/4, which is equivalent to 1/2, 3/4, and 4/4, which is equivalent to 1. Now counting to the left of 0, we have 0 and then negative 1/4, negative 2/4, which is equivalent to negative 1/2, negative 3/4, negative 4/4 is equal to negative 1, negative 5/4, negative 6/4, which is equivalent to negative 3/2, negative 7/4, negative 8/4, which is equivalent to negative 2, and finally negative 9/4. So now we know A is equal to negative 2, B is equal to negative 2/4, which we'll come back to in just a moment because this fraction does simplify, and C equals 3/4. Looking back at the fraction of negative 2/4, more formally, this fraction does simplify because 2 and 4 share a common factor of 2. To simplify, we divide the numerator and denominator by 2. Simplifying, we get negative 1/2. So negative 2/4 equals negative 1/2. So both fractions are correct, but the simplified fraction is the fraction at negative 1/2. If we look back at the number line and focus on the length from 0 to negative 1, we know this length is 1 unit. If we cut or divide this length into two equally sized parts or pieces, each of these smaller lengths is equal to 1/2 of a unit. So starting at 0, moving to the left, we have 0, negative 1/2, and then negative 1. This shows negative 2/4 is equivalent to negative 1/2. I hope you found this helpful.